This is a video on how to use the Google Sheets spreadsheet program, Statistics by Larry Green. We're going to be looking at just the one variable statistics for this particular video. So if this is your first time using this program, you start out by going to File, and then make a copy, give it a name, and hit OK. This isn't my first time, so I'm just going to cancel it and not do that. So what we're going to do is we're going to put our data into column A. To do that, first, I'm going to clear out column A. So I click on column A, that little arrow, and I just go to clear column. Then I put in my data. So I type in number one. So my data here, by the way, is the test scores on the final exam, for example. So if someone got an 84, hit enter, and then a 72, enter, 67, enter, 98, enter. And then I put the last few in. So 87, 91, 65, 77, and 79. And that was my class, and that's how they did on the final exam, in theory, of course. So I want to just look at the statistics. One of the cool things is as I type these in, it actually changes all the statistics as I type it in. I don't have to do anything. So now I could just look, and I could say the mean was 80.5. The sample standard deviation was around 11. Variance was 121. The low score was 54. The first quartile was 75. The median was 80. The third quartile was 88.5. The maximum was 99. And there were 36 students that took the test. So notice that it also shows a histogram. So we can look at this histogram. And it's definitely a unimodal histogram. Looks like in the high C, low B range. And I don't know if it's normal or not. It's not that far from being normal, but it's not that close either. We can also look at some other graphs. If I go to stats right here, and I can go to box plot, and it'll show the box plot. So I click on box plot. So it's on the right, so let me send this over to the right. And there's my box plot. It shows the interquartile range pretty well as a box. We have the median, which is 80. The minimum was 54, and the max was 99. I can also go to stats, and instead I can go to stem and leaf plot. And there's the stem and leaf plot. Okay, so we could see that there were four scores that were 79%. Okay, and we could look at all the rest of the scores too on the stem and leaf plot. Let me show you a few more things that this does. Let me move it back to the right. On the stem and leaf plot, I could choose what the stems and leaves are. The default is that the stems are tens and the leaves are ones. But if I wanted to make them 100, I'd turn this to a 2. And that makes them hundreds. Then I would have to go again to stem and leaf and have it regenerate it. I'm going to put it back to 1 because that's really what I want for this one. Similarly with the box plot, I can include outliers or I can not include outliers. So with no, it means that do include, and yes means do not include outliers. I can compute a confidence interval. So I could choose my confidence level. 95% is standard, and it'll give me the lower and the upper bound for the confidence interval. I could also run a hypothesis test. Let me scroll a little bit. So I can choose whether it's a left tail, a right tail, or a two-tailed test. So for example, I could put not equal to, and that'll give me a two-tailed test. And then I could choose my mu naught. Maybe, I don't know, how about 80, for example. We can see we get our test statistic T, and we get the p-value, 0.79 or so. Other statistics, we could do our trim mean, give the percent, that we want to trim, and we'll show you what the trim mean is. So if I want the 5% trim mean, then that'll do it for me. Here, there's no outliers. There's nothing really too much to trim here. And then I can also find a z-score. So if I want a z-score for the person who got, say, a 99%, hit enter, and that z-score is 1.68 or so. And then there's a whole bunch of other statistics I can do. Here's the population standard deviation. I'll let you read through the rest of them, and I can look at the percentiles. That's about all I have to say about the one-var stats function. So I hope you find this pretty simple to use. And if you want to see anything else or if something's confusing, there are instructions in here. If you go to stats, you can go to instructions, and it'll give you a set of instructions on how to use all of this. And if you want to see more, drop me an email, let me know, and maybe I'll try and include more stuff. So thank you for watching.